Get over there.
It's not right there.
Yeah, that's gonna help you.
Stop rolling. Come on, get over there. Put some high there.
Come on.
Come down.
I don't see a disc.
Up in the air.
There you go, hammer.
Come on, bro.
Yeah, Barsby.
Barely clipped it.
Yeah. Good line, though.
Yeah.
You're low. Nothing. I thought that was good.
Come on, baby.
Hit that. Four!
Kiss it.
Oh, I didn't hit it.
I threw it in from there already this time. Not a chance.
Do it.
Driver.
fight another day on that one.
Yeah. For sure.
Oh, again, kick left. Why are you grip locking this hole so bad?
Go.
What is so hard about that shot, man?
There you go.
Yeah, I just, I don't know. It's weird not playing.
Yeah.
Go.
Move the sign.
Hey.
Yeah.
Wow. Didn't even see it.
I know. I thought it.
Skip up there.
Come out.
Go.
Turn.
Go knee. Head of the duty.
Sit.
Sit.
Happy birthday.
Get under it.
Yeah.
Miss it all.
Yeah.
Nate.
Woo!
Yeah.
Cool.
stayed up.
Oh, early. You're lucky.
Yeah.
Hey. Yeah.
Dang. Barsby, get in the hole.
Come on.
Come on. Get up in the world.
like it. He's like that.
Nice level up.
Atta boy. This is your fourth time. Good shit, man.
Thanks,
good
man.
Playing, dude.
Thank you.
Yeah, man.
Happy birthday.
You're man, dude. Thanks.
Good win.
Happy birthday.
Make that
pop. Not really.
It looked like you just threw it.
Happy birthday, dear Nate. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you!
I'm the Disc Golf Guy, and this is my video blog. I've caught up with our Masters Cup Women's Champion, Paige Pierce. Paige, how does it feel?
It feels awesome. I've actually never won this tournament, so this was a nice one to add to the...
to the list.
Yeah.
Speaking of never winning, it seems like you never lose, actually, this year. How many tournaments have you won?
This is my 10th.
Out of?
11.
Yep. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
What have been the keys to your success this year?
I think just like having fun. The past couple years, I've just been like really focusing and trying as hard as I can. And sometimes when you try too hard, you know, you create unnecessary pressure.
Mm-hmm.
And so I just, you know, it started becoming like monotonous in the aspect where you're just like throwing just because it's your job.
Yeah.
And, you know, this is awesome that it's my job, don't get me wrong, but I was looking past that, so it seems like I'm having fun with it again, and I think that's translating in my score.
So with some of that fun you're having, do you have to directly pay Madison because she's,
yeah,
she's aiding in that fun while you guys are out on the tour?
Well, it's not really directly paying because I don't hand her money.
Okay, but you're paying in experiences.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Back and forth.
I mean, I pay for, you know, her food sometimes. And,
that's fair. You know. She's kind of like a caddy and a personal life,
yes,
mentor, coach thing, right?
A life happiness mentor.
Wow. That's a good one. Life happiness mentor. Those are pretty big words to live up by.
Yeah. Don't tell her I said that.
she doesn't watch these anyway.
No, she won't watch. I'm just kidding. She watches them all. She's your biggest fan.
She better be.
Yeah.
Anyway, so you had a good battle with Valerie Jenkins, and you guys came down to Sunday, and then there was some separation here today. And I'm going to kind of go on record and say that seemed to be what happened with Paul and Nate Doss, is there was a little separation here finally on Sunday. What was the difference today versus, say, the last 2 days?
I actually shot the exact same I did yesterday, today. So I think it was just like kind of steady, playing steady. The past 2 days I had a lot of fours, but a lot of birdies. And so today I was trying not to focus too much on birdies, just trying to three them. So not getting aggressive on the putts and just maybe laying up sometimes and just taking threes. Yeah.
You well, do
this,
that.
At
you
this
do
course,
that, don't you?
You have to, yeah. But yeah, I didn't take too many fours today. So it just was a steady round pretty much. Nothing too special, nothing, you know, really that bad.
All right. So I've got to ask, what is your favorite hole out here at De La Viega?
Huh, I think my favorite hole would be hole 7 and hole 8, hole 9, 10, 11, that whole stretch.
Okay.
It's hard to pick a favorite hole when there's 24 like amazing holes, but it's, yeah, that stretch right there is fun, it's challenging, and you know, like anything could happen. They're all gettable, but they're also fiveable, sixable, so that's a fun stretch, and it really like challenges you in all aspects of the game. So.
Fair enough. Now, if there's one hole out here
one
that you
hole.
Don't look forward to, what
oh,
would that be?
Oh, that I don't look forward to.
Yeah, that you don't look forward to.
For some reason, hole 8A, I'm just like, it's the second shortest hole in the course, and I just can't connect on it. Can't do it.
All right. Well, this, again, is Paige Pierce. She's been out here dominating the tour. How many national tours is that then for you this year? Three or
three.
Four?
Yep.
Three of three.
Yep.
Okay,
yep.
That's good. All right, she's got 3 of 3 national tours. Again, it's been an amazing time out here in California. We're thankful to everyone over at DGA for help getting the Disc Golf Guy out here. Thankful to Paige for going out and dominating and catching up with us. Again, congratulations.
Thank you very much, and
right.
Thanks for covering us.
I'm the Disc Golf Guy, and this is my video blog. With all this sweet Disc Golf Masters Cup action brought to you by DGA this week, I have now caught up with our four-time champion here at the Masters Cup, Paul McBeth. Paul, four times. I don't know if anyone else has ever won it four times, and I'm going to put you on blast. You couldn't even let Nate Doss win out here on his birthday.
On the 30th annual. On his 30th birthday. On his home crowd.
You are truly a McBeast. What brings you out on Saturday and puts you into that, or I'm sorry, here on Sunday, that puts you in domination mode?
I like the pressure. I mean, I play for the pressure. I enjoy it. I feel like that's what we all play for. So I enjoy having it all on the line and just playing in front of a crowd. And it's just fun to me.
At one point, I think you had put together four or five birdie twos out here, which is pretty incredible. Were you just in a roll? Were you in a zone? What were you thinking as things were seemingly going pretty right for you?
I played with Nate all three rounds. So I knew the first two rounds, he started out really hot. So I couldn't get left behind early, because then it'd be tough to battle back, especially with the middle section and then the finishing holes. So I knew I had to go out and go for every hole early. And I was able to capitalize on most of them and get a few stroke lead that I was able to hold on to.
One thing that we saw is right off the bat, four very good drives, four of the best drives I've seen all weekend on hole number one, and not everyone was able to capitalize. Do you think about any of the early holes, like one or two? I mean, those aren't gimmies by any means.
Like hole one, I don't expect to do it. That's the closest I've gotten since I put the new walls up, and I just went off the top. But for the other three to be closer, even closer, than I was incredible. I have four inside 45, 50 feet. So, but one and two are tough to get.
Yeah. So during the final stretch, you had at one point a three or maybe even four stroke lead. And it seemed like it was kind of just obvious how this was going to finish out. And then Nate battled back. You took a bogey on 19, and Nate was right there on the door. And then you guys both birdied 25. Which rarely do you see any birdies, as you said earlier in the week, and then you guys get two of them, and he gets the next hill. What are you thinking when all of a sudden he's only down to you by one?
Yeah, he came charging back. I forwarded hole 19 yesterday. I believe it's 19, right before we crossed the road. I forwarded it yesterday, forwarded it today. But I was able to come back on, like you said, 25. I got a two both days. Nate got it today with a big putt. But like I said earlier, I enjoy that pressure. So seeing him, put more pressure on me is fun to me. So I was excited to see him play well, especially through that stretch, getting three of the final four. It's impressive.
Yeah, he kept it right on you. And then you get up to the top of the world hole. We see you for the third day in a row go with a forehand drive. And that was after Nate came up a bit short. Do you feel like the pressure was off a little bit when Nate had what seemed to be a three lined up?
I still thought he was going to make it.
Okay.
So I had the mindset of making my putt up until he missed it. And then once I got to my putt, I kind of lobbed it up there.
And it still went in.
Yeah, I think that circle's a little small. So it's just it's closer than I anticipated.
Well, it was kind of a beautiful finish in the sense you've got your four-time Masters Championship. Nate had his birthday. There was a huge crowd, huge gallery. It's kind of hard to battle against that. You're up here in NorCal versus SoCal. Did Nate have the crowd behind him? Could you feel that the whole round?
I think it was pretty even, though, honestly. But they were cheering louder for Nate when he threw a good drive. But it seemed like everyone was rooting everyone the same.
All right. Well, it was a pleasure watching you guys all week. I got to see all three rounds with both of you. We saw a few people come in and go on the leader card, but it was truly an amazing battle for the whole weekend. I've got to thank Bill Sherman and DGA, everyone else that helped make this weekend possible so that we could bring you Masters coverage throughout the entire weekend. For Paul McBeth, your four-time champ, I'm Terry Miller, the Disc Golf Guy. Thanks, and we'll catch you guys next time when you don't get daylight.
Happy birthday, Nate.
I'm the Disc Golf Guy, and I've caught up with the Steady Ed Trophy winner in Nate Doss, who's also on his birthday. Nate, we've talked to Paige, we've talked to Paul McBeth, our champions. Unfortunately, you were a tad short here today, but does it really matter? I mean, look at the day you're having.
Yeah, it doesn't really matter. I mean, I said it this morning before I even came out to the course. I want to go out, have a great birthday round with three other great competitors, and play my favorite tournament and play my favorite holes and plays that I played all over the world. And honestly, it's just being able to play is the best birthday gift of it all. And then to to receive a trophy like this.
Here, let me.
Yeah, it's a little heavy, but
let's hoist it a little so everyone can see while you talk.
Yeah. It's you know, I'll never forget when they first gave this trophy out. I just thought it was so cool, and you know, you just at one point you think, well, maybe, you know, and for this day to come is just epic, man.
Well, it's been an amazing weekend. You had a great battle. Again, we talked with Paul about it. Something about running that guy down on Sundays is tough for anybody to do, but you were right there. You were all the way down. There was drama all the way to the last hole. That's what disc golf fans want to see. Obviously, a lot of people pulling for you, and it was just great to see.
Yeah, I mean, the final word, for me, it's the greatest birthday gift in the world to be able to play the game that I've played my entire life against the best player in the world, and for something as great as this tournament. If I never win this tournament in my life, that's fine with me, because I've been able to battle guys like Ken, Barry, Paul, Steve Rico, Gregg Barsby, the list goes on and on and on. And, you know, I put myself out on the line at this tournament every single year. You know, there's so many people that are, you know, come on, Nate, come on, dude, come on, let's do it. You know, it's yours. And I appreciate every single one of those. But in all seriousness, winning the Worlds here in 2011 was like winning 10 Masters Cups. I mean, seriously, because it was just, to be able to pull off a win in Santa Cruz was just amazing. So, yeah, I'm just proud of everything, really.
You should be. Well, for DGA, for your sponsor, Discraft, for Steady Ed, for all of Santa Cruz, and for the rest of the world, again, this is Nate Doss, everyone's champion. Congratulations, buddy.
Thanks
again.
Man. Yeah.
We'll catch you guys next time when we leave. Where are we?
Santa Cruz! Cheers.